complete turncoat to womankind. She gets out there, she gets to the position of power, she gets all of her accolades and awards and all of this fawning praise and money. And when she has a chance to do something for women coming up behind her, she pulls up the ladder.
That is Megyn Kelly, absolutely aggrieved that South Carolina women's basketball coach Dawn Staley is a turncoat to women for reasons which we will describe. What you should bear in mind is the team just won their third NCAA championship. She's apparently the first black coach to win three Division I basketball titles. It is a moment of incredible historic triumph. And of course, the right wing has to find something to be mad about. And so they take a statement that she said and lose their mind over it. She said, if you consider yourself a woman and you want to play sports or vice versa, you should be able to play. And so Megyn Kelly loses her mind. Take a look at this.
There's this columnist over at USA Today Sports, Nancy Armour, who's a repeat violator of women's rights. She can't find the female athlete she wants to protect, who also tweeted out, Dawn Staley is a goddamn national treasure. You're a goddamn national disgrace, madam, because you have a pen in a very large newspaper, dwindling though by the day. And you too could stand up for women, but you're too cowardly to do it. And you know why? You're not a mother. You don't have to worry about your daughter having to face some 6'4" man out on the basketball court like I do.
Yes, Megyn Kelly loses a lot of sleep over that fear. It's not grifting to her audience who she knows are deeply transphobic. It's not that at all. It's a genuine fear. And that writer should shut up because she's not a mother. She doesn't have a kid. She doesn't have a daughter. She doesn't have any position to talk about that. Well, Megyn Kelly, I have a daughter. You shut the hell up. How about that? I think that she should, I want her to engage in sports because I actually care about women's sports. It's not just a position that you and other right wingers take to use to attack trans people. And I hope that she engages with it. And I hope that she engages with it with people who are actively pursuing their love of sport, regardless of whether you like their life decisions or whatever. So anyway, we have other stuff to get to on this, but Sharon, what do you make of this? I know you'd been previously talking about this win.
Yeah, Dawn Staley is a national treasure. And Megyn Kelly, I thought maybe she was looking in the mirror when she uttered that. By the way, her daughter is not facing a 6'4" man, as she made sure to say on the court, yeah, because this is a non-issue and she should stand down and stop trying to hurt people. But then again, hurt people. She's angry and upset at her circumstance, and all the money in the world is not going to change that.
Yeah. 100%. Nancy Mace also, I don't want to just focus on Megyn Kelly. Nancy Mace, who's from that state, that's where she represents, says, wonder how she'd feel if her team got beat with a man playing on the opposing team. Absolute lunacy. Men do not belong in the locker room. Oh, well, they're not actually, conveniently, yeah, because they're not men. Hey, problem solved. Nancy Mace, read a book. Or on the court with our women and girls, I will stop at nothing to ensure men do not take away the achievements of women and girls. I'm sure she will tirelessly fight for that. And then like every other right winger that has made this their entire personality over the last few years, will completely ignore everything else having to do with women's athletics. I will just remind everyone, virtually every one of the right wingers that has spent 3 years talking about how there is nothing more important than women's sports when the topic is trans people's participation in it, are going to go on a rant today about how utterly irrelevant women's basketball is. You know they will. The fact that they got higher ratings than the men is burning them up inside. And every single man in right-wing media of politics or in sports who've never achieved a damn thing in their life athletically cannot help but pass to take an opportunity to point out that women are not as athletically gifted as men. Like, that is so deeply important to these men who are in terrible shape and have never done anything physically. I don't know why that is, but they are going to be all over the place. And I think that that is deeply hypocritical. Any other thoughts before we close out?
Well, I should mention this, and I don't even know if it's relevant. Dawn Staley honed her game, perfected it, playing street pickup ball in Philadelphia against men who respected her and her game, and she's better for it. Look at her now, history books.
No. If a woman gets on the court with a man, that woman will spontaneously combust. That's a biological fact, and that's the way it has to be.
Cheryl Miller, Candace Parker. Okay.
Anyway, also want to acknowledge, seems like the sort of thing that should be a part of this conversation. As Jamel Hill points out, there isn't a single transgender woman competing in Division I women's basketball.
Oh.
Again, I bet if you polled right wingers, they would say that like 30% of athletes are trans at this point. They don't know and they don't care. When you click the join button and become a tier 2 member, you get access to all of our weekly top 10 lists. What are you waiting for?